For another Workout Wednesday, we have our amazing fitness expert, Heather Wilson-Phillips. Today, we are talking about your abs. You guys, 10 minutes is all you need. Heather, welcome.
Thank you.
Okay, so sit-ups are not enough. Why is that?
Sit-ups are not enough because it's not going to work all of your abdominal muscles. No.
Why, you tell me this now.
I know, but I love sit-ups, though, but it's just not going to work everything. So we're going to do some exercises that are going to work everything today.
Right, because like we've got our full abs, we have our lower abs, we've got abs that are like way in there.
Our transverse abdominals, we've got our obliques.
Yeah, we got
a lot of stuff going on.
Okay, so let's start with our full abs. What do we do?
So we're going to start off by doing a genie abs.
Okay.
Okay, so we're going to sit down right on top of our glute.
Do I need to sit just like you?
Oh, yeah,
like
we're going to sit onto our glutes.
Okay. All right.
So we're gonna cross our hands right in front.
Okay.
Okay. And then you're gonna rock a bit back and lift your legs up. So here you are.
Okay.
You're gonna pull it in and kick it out.
Oh, without going down?
Yes, exactly. I know.
That's so hard.
Can you feel that? I know. I'm shaking. Bring it in.
Okay.
And put it back out.
Oh, I'm trying. Everything is squeezed. Gosh, okay.
So that's genie abs, and that's working everything. So if you can get the momentum going, you're here.
I was like, this is working my neck. This is working my fingers, my toes. Everything is getting a workout. That's amazing. Okay.
Yeah.
How many do we want to do of those?
So you're going to want to do about 10 to 12 reps.
Okay.
So everything we're doing today is going to be 3 to 4 sets, 10 to 12 reps to get it in 10 minutes or less.
Okay, sounds good.
Yes.
How do we get those lower abs? I know for so many people, women in particular, that can be a really tricky spot, especially after you've had the babies.
Right. So your transverse abdominals. Planks are a good exercise for that.
Okay.
Also, we have scissors.
Okay.
So I can show you how to do scissors if you want to get the deepest level of our abs going.
Okay.
So we're gonna lay back.
Okay.
Okay.
Right down, head down.
Head down, yep.
Okay.
So we're gonna be here. So you can lift your legs up.
Okay.
And you're gonna be crossing in front.
Oh my
God. So this is your scissors.
Okay.
Yeah. Open and close, yeah.
This is not easy.
I know. So as you go over top and underneath, that's one rep.
Okay.
Over top and underneath, that's two.
And then, Heather, am I trying to, like, push my back into the floor?
Pushing your back, that's right. Pushing your back into the floor and making sure it's nice and firm. Keeping your abs nice and tight. So that's your scissors.
Oh, my God. Okay, great.
You can really feel that, right?
No, not at all. Not at all. Yes, my entire body hurts. Perfect.
So I want to show you as well for your lower abdominals as well.
Okay.
We're going to do flutter kicks.
Okay.
So we're laying back on the mat again.
Back on the floor.
Okay. So we're back here. So our legs are coming up again.
All right.
But this time, we're going up and down.
Oh, wow. Like right into like almost a 90.
Yes.
Okay.
So here we are. Try to see if you can go like just a little bit faster.
Okay.
And you're breathing.
Good reminder.
Don't hold your breath. Right. We don't want you to pass out. Just make sure you're still breathing here.
Oh, wow.
Okay. And you're going to feel that in your lower abdominals.
Yeah, totally. That's like a whole core workout. Amazing.
Yes.
Okay. What about the deepest level of our abs?
The deepest. So we did scissors, for example. That was going to work. Yes.
Okay.
That worked our deepest level. But we also did the plank, because the plank is going to work your deepest level of your abs as well, too. So that's another alternative as well. If you can't do the scissors, you can do the plank exercise as well.
Okay.
Yes.
We often want to target the side of our abs. What are those ones called? The
obliques.
Okay.
Yes.
How do we get those?
So what we're going to do is I'm going to show you an exercise called a candlestick dipper.
Okay.
Have you ever done that before?
No.
Okay.
I don't think so.
Okay. Let me show you what it looks like, and then I'm going to come over and make sure we're doing this correctly. So we're going to have one leg extended out.
Okay.
Okay. So we're going to have our hands up over our head, pointing right at the top. And the objective is to come over to the side, right where you feel it, right your obliques. You're coming over, you're holding that. And you come back up to this.
Okay.
So it's right like that.
This doesn't look like it's going to be hard, but knowing you, this is probably going to be the worst moment of my life.
That foot in.
Okay.
There you are.
And now I'm leaning.
So you're leaning.
Oh,
right,
we're really leaning.
Yep.
Oh, we're really leaning.
Can you feel that pull right there?
Yeah.
And then come all the way back up to the center.
Okay, and when am I supposed to breathe?
So you're breathing. So when you're here, as you're going down, you're breathing out. Inhale.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, 10 minutes.
10 minutes.
10 minutes.
10 minutes or less.
Okay, you guys, we are going to look so good heading into summer.
Yeah.
Next Wednesday, Heather will be back with a quick leg workout.